Hi guys, Top Pops here. Today, I'm in the backyard right now. Bailey's out here doing his thing. Took him outside for a bit, but we're going pop hunting in a bit. We're going to be going over to GameStop, Target, maybe Walmart, Foot Locker perhaps. I don't know yet. Pretty much whatever we can while we're there. I don't think there's too much new over at Foot Locker, so maybe not there. Walmart, I've been looking for that glow-in-the-dark Mysterio. So just a couple places, I don't know. But I'm really excited to go to GameStop because I have a couple things saved. Also, the E3 pops are out now. So I want to see if I can grab some of that stuff. I know I'm a little late, but I should be able to get some of the stuff that I want. So anyways, guys, let's get started. Babe, come on. Come on. Hey, come on, let's go in. All right, guys, so our first stop is Walgreens. Let's see what they've got. Actually, haven't been here in a while. It will be cool to see if anything's different, but probably not. All right, so over here at Walgreens, they have, actually, they have one that I haven't seen in a while. Here, actually, it's Punisher 2099. Maybe I've never seen this one, I think, because I got it at EB Games. I didn't get it here, so maybe I've never seen this one, but that's neat. I think back there, I also see, the Walgreens exclusive Hawkeye. So I guess this is a pretty good hunt. I mean, I have, but oh, that's why it's still here. You guys can see the damage there. That's probably why it's here still. I picked one up at this location about a month ago, perhaps. I think it was something like that. So they do have some stuff. It's just not the greatest stuff. I mean, Walgreens never has a great section for pops, but still, they have their exclusives, which is good. So that seems to be about it, but I'm gonna keep looking around and see what else I can find. All right, guys, so I checked all the spots where pops would be, and that seems to be about it. So let's go on to the next store. All right, guys, so we're on our way over to GameStop right now. I'm really excited about this. I just wanted to mention it again because we have a lot of cool stuff that could be here today. I don't know what's gonna be here, but I know for a fact I will have my Stay Puffed Marshmallow Man. That's the only one I know will be in because I had that one on pre-order. We couldn't go last week because of Comic-Con, but Mom, we will be getting it this week, right?
We will be
getting it. That one will be really
cool. Confirmed. I believe it was there the last time we were there, but we weren't allowed to take
it. It was street dated for a certain date, so we couldn't go in and get it.
We know
it's
there.
We know it's there. So anyways, let's go over to GameStop, guys, because it's literally, I hope you guys can see it. It's next to the Great Clips over there.
Hard to see.
Yeah, somewhere over there. I wasn't lying. There was a sign. You could kind of see the Great Clips one, but now you can see the GameStop one. Okay, let's go in. Okay, guys, so GameStop is amazing today. I'm not showing you anything yet because I want to start at the bottom and then we're going to go up to the other stuff. But we've got some of the ones from Community down here. We've got, Mom, they've got Sam from Cheers.
Oh, wow. I didn't even know that was a thing.
Yeah, Sam Mayday Malone.
Oh.
But who's your favorite, Sam or Post?
Sam.
Ah, jeez, all right. They also have Diane, Norm, Cliff, and Woody.
Oh, that'd be
That's
cool.
pretty cool. They never made, what's his name? What's his name? They never made Chief?
Woody.
Is his name? No, Woody's on there. What's his name? The original bartender's name.
Coach.
They never made Coach. Over here, guys, we've got some Stranger Things ones. We've got NSYNC. You guys might be able to see some of it over here. But here are some of the ones here, guys. So these are ones that I'm picking up today. Hanzo and Genji from Overwatch. This is a two-pack. Noah's really going to like this one. But it's going to be a great one for the collection. I also have the Donald E3 Pez over here, as well as Battlehound from Fortnite. This is a really nice pop. I like this one a lot. There's so much going on with this one. It's very detailed. It also glows in the dark. This is the second glow in the dark Fortnite one, I believe. I almost said Overwatch because I was thinking of these two. But then also, guys, they have some other stuff as well. They have Leviathan and Loot Llama, which are two really cool ones that I will be picking up today. And then I only need a couple more for the set. Then I'd only need Tomato Head, DJ Yonder, and then Panda if I get these ones here. And you guys might be thinking, what about the 10-inch one? Well, it's here as well. These ones just came out recently, so I'm going to have to pick this one up as well. And I want to know, guys, let me know in the comment section below, is this brand new? We found this over here. They have two of them, and I was asking around, and the guys that work here said that these ones just came in. He found two of these ones. They had another one up there. It's the same set, just the two-pack as well. So if you guys know anything about this, let me know. I know they made a bloody version of this to box lunch a long time ago with a two-pack, but never a normal one like this. So if you guys have ever seen this, let me know. Could have been an FYE thing, maybe, and now it's just not exclusive, because they do that a lot at FYE. But other than that, they've got the Gears Pop box up here. What else did I see that was new? They got in some Bulbasaurs, which is cool. A lot of the Gears of War pops for the game as well. But yeah, because I'm going to keep looking around, see what else I can find. Oh, they also have Sting from the Police. I don't think I mentioned this one as well. Now, Kenny was saying that he saw Stuart Copeland?
Copeland, yeah.
Without the drum set. Now, I don't know if that's true or not, but could be.
Kenny's pretty accurate.
He is pretty accurate. He saw, like, the actual pop of the drum set.
He doesn't make sense.
So if you guys have seen that one, let me know if it's got the drum set. But other than that, that seems to be about it for the new stuff, so I'm gonna keep looking around and see what else I can find. Over here, guys, on the other side, they have some Dragon Ball Super Pops, Dragon Ball Z, Dragon Ball Super, and then down here, they've got all the Pez. Not too much is new over here, I don't think. They got Slimer in, Sonic, they have the new Donald over here as well. But other than that, that seems to be all the stuff that I have already, so yeah, guys, I think let's just check out and let's keep going. Alright, guys, our next stop is Target. Let's see what they've got. Alright guys, so we're back here over at Target, and funny thing is I just noticed this. I had been trying to find one of these for forever. I'm getting one over at EB Games, so I can't get this one today, but there's that right there. They're getting in a bunch of older stuff here now. Again, I'm noticing they got a Flaming Skeleton, which you never see anymore. It's kind of a weird one to see here. They also got in this one here from Die Hard. I'm not going to be picking this up. A Die Hard Christmas box. And then it's got him on there with the no shirt and cuts and stuff like that, then him bursting through the window. That's pretty cool. They also got in the Prince Hakim and Randy Watson vinyl. That's really neat as well. I'm going to have to show my mom this one, actually. That's cool. Now, one thing that I did notice that they got in, which is something I'm going to want to pick up, is the Caddyshack pop hat and... Well, pop and hat. Sorry, not pop hat and pop, I was going to say. Sorry. Anyways, it's a hat and pop. This is one that I'm going to want to get today. Because I've been looking this one for a while. I really just want this, but I also will probably wear the hat a bit. I don't know. Got a Vretzico over here. Those are really cool ones as well. And then who's this back here? They've got... Oh, the Brady Bunch. This is Greg. And then they also have Odd Job back here. So anyways, two pretty cool things that I'm going to want to check out. I'm going to see if she wants this one. I don't know if she will, but we'll at least show it to her. Okay, guys, so I brought her back here to show her the vinyl pack. They got in the Prince Hakim and Randy Watson.
Yeah, unfortunately, I can't get it because Tristan has already spent too much money.
Over at GameStop, we spent a lot. And if you guys don't know, when we go over the bridge, you have to pay on it. So we're probably going to have to pay a bit today. So we might still have to grab this over here. Because this one, I feel like the Caddyshack box will go quicker than the vinyls. So if we had to pick one or the other. I mean, and do you like the Coming to America ones,
yeah,
though?
Yeah, I actually want them there.
But they have a bunch of them. They only have two or three of the Caddyshack box.
In New York. Which I'm sad I didn't.
Yeah, but we did grab, what did we grab instead? You grabbed a vinyl pack. Oh,
yeah.
You know which one? It was kind of funny. I feel like you maybe should have grabbed that one instead of the other one.
Because the other one.
We see the other one all the time. This one, yeah.
That's okay.
I don't know. Anyway, so we're going to be probably picking up the Caddyshack box. Oh, you know what's funny, Mom? Look at else they got in. Skull Trooper.
That's
so
okay.
It's okay because I have it in Canada. Yeah, so I have one. I got one ordered to the store in Canada, so that's fine. So it looks like that's about it for back here. Oh. Did you know, fun fact, guys?
Wait, stop looking. No. Those were also from...
Yeah, this is from...
And weren't they sold out the first day?
They sold out the first day. This was the first thing that sold out. Which is weird. I wonder if this is worth anything. I'd have to check that. This is the only rock candy with two people in it.
And weird that they have them just randomly.
Well, here what it is. I don't know what it is, but they seem to be getting in a bunch of older stuff. Like exclusives. Like maybe they had extra stock, or maybe other stores had them, or maybe they're making them again. I don't know. I feel like that could be a thing as well, because how could they restock something like from a year later? I don't know where they just find these, you know what I mean? Anyways, I'm going to have to search those up. I'm not going to pick them up. I just want to find out how much they're worth, because it'd be pretty cool to see them a little bit more than, you know, retail. So as I searched it up on the Funko app, it's worth about like $29 to $31, I think was like the average that it said. There was
it's
the
cute though.
Well, it's the like $29, because this is the fall convention one. Wait, what were we saying? Sorry.
It's cute.
Oh, okay. Yeah, well, I mean, here it is here, guys. It's worth $20, but they're selling it for $20, so you would make a little bit off of it, but I would literally buy it just to keep it, because it's a really cool rock candy set. Because it, like I said, the only one with two pops in it. But other than that, they have a lot of Charmanders. They have, I mean, I showed these off already. I'm just kind of doing it again since we're here. They do have the normal gopher as well, if you guys want to see what it would look like without the, this is the same one without the flocking on it. Which is still a really great pop, and I'm excited to get that hat. They also, I didn't show this off before, they got in the Britney Spears box, as well as the Chuck Norris one. And if you guys don't have the Chuck Norris pop, this is the only way you can get it is inside of here, which I think is kind of funny. So there he is right there. I'm not going to be picking it up today because I already have it. But just thought I'd mention it, because it is a little odd that they're getting a lot of this old stuff. What?
I want to ask you a question.
Oh, sure. Hey guys, I was walking by the normal 10-inch section, and they have 10-inch Green Goblin. This is one that's really old. This came out for the 12 Days of Funko for, or was it whatever they did their Christmas thing? I don't remember if it was 12 Days of Funko on the Christmas, around Christmas, but this was so weird that they had this. They have five of them as well. It's not like they just got one of them and maybe someone returned it or something. They got another stock of them, which I thought was kind of cool. So if anybody's looking for this Green Goblin in Niagara Falls at the Target, come check it out.
All right, guys, so I'm in Starbucks right now. Actually, I'm still in Target. It's just funny because it looks like a Starbucks. Anyway, because this is technically a Starbucks. But anyways, we are done with shopping today. I got the Caddyshack box, which I'll open up when we get home, so I can show you the hat and the pop closer up. I also want to show you guys all of the pops that I got close up as well. I also want to do some more E3 hunting tomorrow. I was saying to myself that I wanted to call this an E3 hunt, and then when I ran into all of the Fortnite stuff, I'm going to be calling it more of a Fortnite hunt, because that's pretty much what it is, me looking for the Fortnite ones. So anyways, I'll show you everything closer when we get home. I just want to let you guys give you a little update here, because I did get the Caddyshack box. It's going to be fun. So anyways, guys, we'll see you at home. All right, guys, so we are back from the store. Now, this is on the table from yesterday's video. And if you guys want to win a Lion King box from Hot Topic, go to yesterday's video, guys. I should put an eye up in the corner if I remember to do it. Actually, I don't remember which side it is. An eye in the corner somewhere up there, guys. And if you guys want to enter, it's really simple. It's free to enter. Literally anywhere in the world you guys can win. Go do that. But let's go on to... That's not your box, by the way. That's an empty one. Let's go on to the stuff that we picked up today, because I got some really cool stuff, and I want to show it off. Let's start with the Target thing, because that's only one thing. It's the Caddyshack box. The cool thing about this one was it didn't matter what size was left, because it's literally just a hat. So that's fun. Let's actually go inside. Let me show you the box first. I really like the art on this box, and it's got hole 19 on the side there, which I think is funny, and then it's got the Caddyshack hat with the gopher pop. Really, the only thing that's the problem with this one, I guess, would be if the pop comes in all right, because, I mean, with the hat, you really can't ruin a hat. I mean, unless you, like, rip it or something. I don't know how you would. Anyways, let's get into this here, because I'm really excited about this box. Ever since they announced all the Caddyshack pops, I've been super excited about them. So let's see how it did here. Okay, we got the Caddyshack hat, and the pop looks to be pretty good. I don't see anything wrong with it. Nice. Okay, guys, so here is the flocked gopher from Caddyshack. Very cool figure. It's kind of dark in there, but you can still see him. Yeah, same pop, just flocked, so that's cool. Now let's check out the hat. I will be saving this box, probably, just because I like the way it looks. It's actually pretty nice, I'm not going to lie. I like this. Too bad they didn't make that a pop there, if that was the exclusive one inside. Like, inside, like a dirt pile or something like that. That would have been cool. But, I mean, it's a lot more work to do that. Just do literally a flocked one, and I love it still. So let's see what we got going on with the Caddyshack hat. I'll probably wear this for the rest of the episode. I'm not such a fan of flat caps like this. But it's a Funko hat, so you can't go wrong with it. It is the Bushwood one, which is the country club that they work at or whatever, and that's the one in the movie. Anyways, very cool. This is the hat that they wear in the movie. I'll wear it for now. I might just keep it on the shelf. I don't know if I'll wear it for forever. But it still is a pretty cool hat, and I'm glad that I got this. So, let's go on to the rest of the stuff here, starting with the... let's do the smaller pops that we got at GameStop first. So I got a couple things. Some pretty cool things, too. This has pretty much been my best hunt in a long time. Starting with Leviathan here, which is really cool. This one's nice because it's the dome one. I remember a long time ago I really wanted Funko to make the Leviathan one. I'm going to take this off for now. I really wanted Funko to make the Leviathan pop, and I'm glad that they did. It looks amazing. One thing that I wish they did, which would have been cool, is if they put a little bit of clear plastic for the neck and then made it so his head was floating in the middle, because it is a fish, right? So they show it on the side where it's not connected, but of course it's got to be connected. So there's something in there to connect the pieces. But other than that, it's an amazing pop. I think it looks great. So there's Leviathan. The other Fortnite one that we picked up was this one here, Loot Llama. I actually want to take this one out of the box to see what it looks like. The Loot Llama one is really, really cool. I like the way they made the eyes look kind of like, it's like almost like fading purple. I don't even know what to call it. Gradient is the word I'm looking for. The eyes look great. This whole thing just looks amazing. I love this pop. It's got the chest on the side of it instead of... It's got something else in the game. I don't remember exactly what it is, but it's not a chest. The Loot Llama is a really cool pop. Now from this set, I just need DJ Yonder, Tomato Head, and Panda Team Leader. And I asked at GameStop, and they said they were in transit. So that's pretty cool. So they should be in soon. We'll be doing a video on those. If you guys want to see a full review on all of them once I get them all, there might be another one for San Diego Comic-Con, but that's not till like August. So we can do a review on all of them once I get in my exclusive Bright Bomber from Amazon. That'd be cool. And then I got to get the one from... what's the one?
from Best Buy as well. That'd be cool. So anyways, there's those two. So that's it. Oh, no, no. There's one more Fortnite one. We also got this one here. We got Battlehound from E3. That one's really cool as well. There was a huge Fortnite booth at E3 this year. So it's cool that I got this one as well. I actually haven't seen this one out of the box. Let me take this one out real quick. I've seen it as in, like, you know, photos of it, but I haven't held it in person. This is really nice. So the parts that glow on this one for the glow-in-the-dark are just the eyes up there, which is still really cool. But there he is right there. There's Battlehound. Very cool figure. I like the metallic on it with the, you know, kind of like normal colored paints, I guess, which you call it matte. Yeah, it does come with a stand. I'm not going to take it out right now because, you know, stands are like normal. But I also really like his axe as well. It's pretty neat. It's got like a wolf on it I'd say it's a wolf, something like that. Anyways, there it is right there. I think you guys can kind of see it. Yeah, there, right there. Pretty neat. Anyways, this is the E3 exclusive one. E3 was just this weekend or last weekend, I think it was. All of these came out Wednesday, so I missed the Wednesday, but I still did get them today, which is awesome. So I could have got everything that I wanted. They literally had every E3 pop at the store, so that's cool. So there's the three Fortnite ones that I got today. Three really cool ones. I'm super glad that I could get these ones. They're all really nice ones. But let's move on to the next stuff here. So I got another two pops and a Pez. The one set of pops is Hanzo and Genji. These ones look amazing in person. And I actually freed up a spot for a two-pack over here, so I have some room for it. It'll probably be going right over here. I have three spots for two packs. And I sold a couple at Comic-Con. I had run out of room before, and now I have a little bit of room, which is nice. So we'll be throwing these ones right over here. Actually, let's do it right now anyway. Can you guys see those over there? Yeah, that'll look nice in the background from now on. The Hanzo and Genji 2-pack. Pretty cool. So, one more thing that I got over there was the Donald Pez from Kingdom Hearts. This one's really cool. So this is him with his funky little hat. I don't exactly know which Kingdom Hearts this is from. It just says Kingdom Hearts. But still, very cool Pez. It has got the E3 sticker on. I think it's the same size as the normal stickers. Yeah, it might be a little smaller. No, it's the same size. Sometimes they shrink the stickers for the Pez, which is kind of cool. But for this one, it's a normal size sticker for the Pez. But still, very cool. I like to get all the Pez when I can, and I'm glad that I could pick up this one. So there's that right there. Let me just put them right here. I guess you can kind of see them. Anyways, let's go on to the next stuff here, which is the two 10-inch pops that I got. Both of them are amazing. I'm really excited about this Loot Llama as well. The 10-inch Loot Llama is one of my favorite 10-inch ones that I own. I'm really excited that I could get it. So here we go, guys. This is it right here. So cool. This is probably the reason you guys clicked on this video, if you guys are going for the Loot Llama here. So this one also has the chest on it. I'm not exactly sure what it was before, but I know it's not the chest. No, if you can find a photo of that, let me know. But there it is right there, guys, the Loot Llama. Here's the difference between this one and then the normal one. This is literally them next to each other. The 10-inch one is massive. I don't know if it's exactly 10 inches tall. The SpongeBob one was only 7 or 8, somebody said. But this one is probably 10 inches because of the ears, maybe even a little bit higher. But such an amazing figure. Now, I did get one more thing, and I want to show you that as well before we go. We grabbed this as well. Now, this one is pretty cool as well. I've had this one saved there for a little while now because I haven't been able to pick it up. But here is the other one. This is the 10-inch Stay Puft. Now, this one is amazing. This one's really cool. I like this one a lot. I wish they made a burnt one as well, which I think would have been really cool. But I just love this thing. So this Stay Puft right here is from the Funko Insider Club. It normally is the GameStop sticker, but I guess they put the Funko Insider Club on this one. But that is such a cool figure. It's so big. These two are both the same size box, and they are just both massive. It's hard to show them all off, but there they are right there. Anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys want to see more from me in the future, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. All of this stuff is awesome, but I want to hear your guys' opinion. What was your favorite thing that I got out of today's haul? This is way more than I usually get for a normal pop hunt on the weekend like this. We usually try to do one pop hunt every weekend, and this one's way more than normal. So anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys want to see more from me in the future, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, do all that. But this has been another episode of Top Pops. Popsters, thanks for watching. Let's go in, babe. Come on. Oh, you want to go say hi to your friends? Go.